If you've had Fusarium wilt confirmed in one of the fields on your farm, the post-harvest period is really important as part of the management for this disease. Beth, I was wondering if you could tell me a little bit about some of the important steps you might take in the post-harvest period if you've got Fusarium wilt.
Sure thing, Paul. So it's really important, first of all, to make sure that it is Fusarium wilt and not verticillium wilt, as the two wilt diseases can be very difficult to differentiate in the field. So you've got to make sure you're sending samples away to one of the cotton pathologists for testing.
So after picking, what's the first step I might take in this field, for example, as we enter the post-harvest period?
It's mandatory in bollgard cotton to mulch your crop after picking. And usually this is then worked into the field, but it's best if Fusarium is confirmed to leave that mulched trash on the surface for 90 days up to 120 days where it's possible. There's currently no crop rotations advised for managing Fusarium wilt, but in saying that, growing another crop is still better than leaving a bare fallow. So you've just got to make sure that after you grow your crop, you bury that stubble or trash as quickly as possible after harvest, so that they break down faster and don't act as a food source for the Fusarium.
And when preparing for the next cotton crop, is there anything that we need to consider?
Research has shown that the type of nitrogen can influence the severity of Fusarium wilt in a field. Urea is preferable to anhydrous ammonia. In-crop irrigation management can make a difference to Fusarium. The pathogen can be soil-borne or waterborne, so it's important not to get too much tailwater running off the field and backing up. Try to water those fields last so that you're not recycling water to other non-infected fields.
What about varieties and time of sowing?
So all the cotton varieties available have an F rank, which is a score relating to how well they can cope with Fusarium wilt in a field. So you want to choose the highest F rank you can that's suitable to your region. Sowing a field that has Fusarium later is better because the temperatures will be warmer and it'll be less conducive to disease.
And what about farm hygiene? What are the key points that we'd consider there?
So in terms of farm hygiene, it's really important to remember to come clean, go clean, and that's on farm and between farms. So make sure you wash down equipment after you've been in a field known to have Fusarium wilt. You can find more information on Fusarium management on the CottonInfo website, the Cotton Pest Management Guide, or talk to your local REO and they'll point you in the right direction.